The ultimate showdown: Linux Mint 22.2 versus Debian 13.1. Stability and security explained. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're here, it's because you care deeply about the foundation of your Linux system. That invisible backbone that keeps everything running smoothly without crashes, glitches, or security headaches. Today, we are diving into the ultimate comparison between two powerhouse distributions, Linux Mint 22.2 and Debian 13.1. I'll break down their stability and security head to head, uncovering what makes each one tick and helping you decide which is the better fit for your setup. Whether you are a beginner looking for hassle-free computing or a pro prioritizing ironclad reliability, stick around. I got actionable insights coming your way. First, let's meet our contenders. Linux Mint 22.2, codenamed Zara, is the latest long-term support release from the Linux Mint team, dropped just a few days ago in early September 2025. It's built on Ubuntu 24.04 LTS, which itself draws from Debian's rock-solid base. But Mint amps up the user-friendliness with polished desktop environments like Cinnamon, Mat, or XFCE. Its primary aim: to deliver an elegant, easy-to-use OS that's comfortable for everyday tasks, from web browsing to media editing, without overwhelming new users. On the other side, Debian 13.1, codenamed Trixie, is the freshest point release of Debian 13, which hit stable status on August 9, 2025. With the 13.1 update following on September 6 for bug fixes and security patches, Debian positions itself as the universal operating system, emphasizing free and open source software principles. It's designed for versatility across desktops, servers, and even embedded devices, with a laser focus on stability over flashy features. No frills here, just pure dependable Linux. Both distros share Debian DNA, but they diverge in philosophy. Mint prioritizes accessibility and modern conveniences, while Debian leans into uncompromising reliability and transparency. Now, let's get into the deep dive on stability and security to see how this play out in real-world use. When it comes to stability, that is, how well your system holds up under daily use without unexpected downtime or software conflicts, both distros shine, but their approach differs significantly. Debian 13.1's stability is legendary, thanks to its rigorous release freeze process. Before a stable version like Trixie goes live, packages undergo extensive testing in the unstable SID and testing branches. This means only thoroughly vetted software makes it to stable, minimizing bugs and ensuring compatibility even with cutting-edge hardware like RISC-V architectures. In practice, this translates to fewer updates overall, reducing the risk of breakage. If you're running a server or need a set-it-and-forget-it setup, Debian's architecture excels. It's less likely to introduce surprises during routine operations. Linux Mint 22.2, meanwhile, inherits much of its stability from its Ubuntu LTS base, which pulls from Debian, but adds a layer of polish for desktop users. Mint builds on this with its own LTS strategy, supported until 2029, and includes tools like system snapshots via Timeshift for easy rollbacks if something goes wrong. It balances stability with new features like updated Cinnamon 6.4 for smoother performance and better hardware support, including fingerprint readers. However, because Mint incorporates more recent packages than pure Debian, there's a slightly higher chance of occasional hiccups during the updates. Though its update manager helps mitigate this by categorizing updates into levels of risk. Real-world implications. Debian might feel more predictable for long-term deployments, with less frequent changes and broader hardware testing. Mint, on the other hand, offers quicker access to new drivers and apps, which can enhance stability on newer hardware, but requires more user oversight. Users on forums often note Debian's edge in raw uptime, while Mint wins for out-of-the-box desktop reliability, fortress or foundation, security paradigms. Security is where these distros really showcase their strengths, both emphasizing protection but through different lenses. Debian 13.1 is a fortress of open source integrity. Its unwavering commitment to free software means every package is auditable by the community, fostering transparency and rapid vulnerability fixes. Security updates are backported to stable without disrupting the system, and features like enhanced kernel hardening, example with Linux 6.12, provide robust defenses against exploits. Default configurations include tools like AppArmor for application sandboxing, and the project security team handles patches efficiently. This makes Debian ideal for environments where data integrity is paramount, like servers or privacy-focused setups. Linux Mint 22.2 adopts a foundational approach, relying on Ubuntu's security team for timely patches while incorporating direct fixes from upstream Debian. It provides 5 years of security updates with defaults like a built-in firewall via UFW and no unnecessary data collection, putting users in full control. Mint's update manager adds user-friendly tiers, letting you apply critical security fixes without risking stability from optional updates. While it doesn't match Debian's purest FOSS ethos, it includes some proprietary drivers for ACEs. It's hardened against common threats and benefits from Ubuntu's proactive vulnerability scanning. Now, key similarities. Both prioritize timely patches for 0 days and use similar tools like SE Linux options for advanced hardening. The difference is, Debian's transparency might give it a slight edge in audibility, but Mint's user-centric design makes security more accessible for non-experts. Community feedback highlights Debian's superior track record in production security, though Mint holds its own for desktops. Now, the update dilemma: speed versus safety. Updates are a double-edged sword. They bring fixes but can introduce instability. Here is how our distros handle the balance. Debian 13.1's stable branch prioritizes safety over speed. Packages are frozen post-release, with updates limited to security patches and critical bug fixes via backports. This means slower delivery of new features but fewer disruptions, perfect for minimizing zero-day exposure in long-running systems. If you need fresher software, you can dip into testing or unstable branches, but they trade safety for speed. Now, Mint 22.2 flips this with its tiered update manager, categorizing updates from level 1, which is safe essential, to level 5, potential risky. This gives user control, apply security patches quickly while holding off on feature updates. Drawing from Ubuntu, Mint gets fixes faster than Debian stable, which helps with emerging vulnerabilities. But it requires more vigilance to avoid breakage. Now, implications. For 0 days, both are responsive, but Debian's model ensures long-term maintenance with less intervention. Mint suits users who want timely enhancements without full rolling release chaos. In essence, Debian favors rock-steady safety, while Mint offers flexibility speed. Now, making your choice beyond the technical. Technical specs are crucial, but doesn't overlook the bigger picture. Both have vibrant communities. Debian's is a massive and developer-focused, acting as a security asset through collective auditing, while Mint's forums are beginner-friendly and quick with practical advice. Hardware compatibility. Mint often edges out with the better out-of-the-box support for Wi-Fi, graphics, and peripherals, thanks to Ubuntu's drivers. Debian requires more tweaks but supports a wider range of architectures long-term. So, who wins? It depends on you. For servers, production, or ultimate stability or security, Debian 13.1 takes the crown. It's the fortress. For daily desktop use with a friendly interface, Linux Mint 22.2 is your go-to foundation, blending reliability with ease. What truly matters? Assess your needs. If you value minimal changes and transparency, go with Debian. For polished usability with solid protections, pick Mint. Test both in a live USB to see what clicks. Thanks for watching. Drop your thoughts in the comments. Which distro are you running and why? Hit like, subscribe, and ring the bell for more Linux deep dives. See you next time. Peace out.